Karibu sana. Welcome to this program of Follow Moses and Africa. I would like to welcome you because you are the children of Abraham, although there are many others in the world. And I would like to summarize the six programs that we have covered. We started with program one. My name is Ruth Engeseni, and in that program one, we looked at the blessings of Abraham in Genesis 12, which was the first blessing that his name will be a blessing to the whole world. And then the second blessing was in Genesis 15, whereby he promised him that all his descendants, he will give them land where they will live. And then come Genesis 17, whereby now we Africa, we are members of that covenant, whereby all the descendants of Abraham, they have to circumcise their male children so that they are members of the covenant that God was making with Abraham. So in that covenant of Abraham, there were three things. One is a promise that his name will be a blessing to all the world. And so being associated with Abraham is already a big blessing. And when he came to Moses, he said, I am the God of Abraham. I'm the God of your forefathers. And so now when we look at the third blessing, whereby he said that, that I will also increase you. You will be a father of many nations. But now on his part, God had done it. He had promised land. He had promised a blessing of Abraham's name. And then he said he will bless him to be of many descendants. So he blessed his seed. He was promising a great seed. So the power to reproduce was given to Abraham. And that is how we see the children of Abraham behaving, having many children, and enjoying their life as fathers and as parents of the descendants who will come after us. So, but Abraham on his part, he had to do something. The only thing God wanted him to do is to agree that he, that God, is the God of Abraham and the God of all descendants. And all his descendants then have to keep this covenant. The sign of this covenant is that they take an oath and get circumcised. As they are getting circumcised, they are adhering to the words of that covenant. So that covenant said that only God Almighty of Abraham is our God. And here in Africa, we are the ones with the circumcision culture. We circumcise our boys from long ago to today until tomorrow. We will do it comfortably in our culture. So we are members of that covenant. But that covenant says that God Almighty, the great God, the Most High, is the God of Abraham, and he is our God. And so when he appeared to Moses, he came with the first commandment, which we Africa are breaking. The first commandment says that I am your God. You shall not have any other God but him. And before that, he mentioned that, he read that commandment, the first commandment. He told Moses that I am the God of your forefathers, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. So that God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob is the God of Africa. And just as he used to talk to our forefathers directly, without through, that is how his children are supposed to worship him, without adding another, without adding so that they are five, and that they, you know, a lot of confusion. Africa, this is the truth. This is the reality, that we have taken an oath of that covenant, and we have a sign in our body to show that we are members and adhering to that covenant of our father Abraham. And then we are going on breaking the words of that covenant. We have got many gods. We are mentioning other that were brought by the colonial powers, and then we are including it in our prayer. That is wrong. We should worship God directly, one by one, talk to him, and he will hear. Just as, for example, you will understand that God really loves men. God, gentlemen of Africa, God really loves you, because even the covenant was given to Moses, who was a man. This covenant, again, agreement, was being done by God to Abraham and his descendants. Then the male descendants are the ones to take over the oath. Now, when we look at men, when you talk to God one by one, the God of Abraham, he hears, and he really listens to you and to your pain. Because when we look at Hagar, and as we call her Hagari in Africa, and we look at that name because it is a Hebrew name. It is one of the Aram names. Hagari, when she was told to go back to her home, because she was not a slave, she was a worker. And when she was told to go back with her son Ishmael, they were given food and water. And when they reached a certain place, that food was finished and water, and it was dry. So she put the boy somewhere so that she cannot see this boy dying. So, and she went to cry in another place. So a distant, you know, she didn't want to see the boy dying. So God later came to this girl, Hagar. He told her, Hagar, wake up. Go and embrace the boy. Comfort him. I have heard his cry, and I have already brought a spring of water. Go take that water and give to the boy. Now, Ishmael was crying, but God heard the cry of Ishmael, the boy who had been circumcised at 13 years when his father was 99. So God said he has heard the cry of Ishmael, the son of Abraham. Because of the sign of circumcision, his channel was one by one. Because of the sign of circumcision, he was sanctified, and his speech to God is direct. So, Africa, there is nothing that should be able to hinder you from talking to God. It is you and God, one by one, because already you have the sign of circumcision on our bodies. And this sign of circumcision is a sign of the covenant of God and Abraham and his descendants. So later in our own programs, we wanted to know, then if we are the children of Abraham because of this sign of circumcision, then let us dig deep and see the origin of Abraham and see whether we are connected. We looked at the children of Shem. And Shem in the Bible, and that is in Genesis, it says that Shem is the father of all the Hebrews. So Hebrews in the world are more, or maybe one third of the population of the world, because the three children of Noah is where the humanity came from. That is Shem, Ham, and Japheth. And Shem was the firstborn. So we found children of Shem being connected to us. Although they connect Africa with Ham, I want to show you that Africa is the children of Shem. Why? Because Ashur was one of the sons of Shem. And Ashur is connected to parts of Kenya and part of South Sudan. Ashur. Then we found Aram. And Aram is one of the languages that writing of the wall, Mene, Mene, Tekel, Ferezi, Pasin, during Daniel's time. And that language we found is an African language. And I in East Africa can understand that language, whereby Mene, Mene is rejected, rejected. Teke, you are useless, you are being hit by the leg. And then Ferezi is quick, and then Pasin. So we found that Aram as a sign of Shem. So then we go on, we find Elam. Elam, we are told that they are the people who are called, they are associated with Shur. And then Aram is associated with Syria. Then again, you see, these are people already we are connected with. But most of all, the firstborn of Shem is a fake sad. A fake, if you check and do research in the internet, a fake is a word that is already in the Bible. And it is during Elisha's death that he told the king, you will fight the Aram until you defeat them in Afek. So Afek is a place, and that is in Africa. That is where our word Africa has come from. And Afek is also, it means a strength, rapid torrent. It is biblical. So after that, we looked stronger at the Aramites people, and we found that Laban, the grandfather of the Israelite children, was an Aram, and he spoke Jagarishahanduda, and that is in Genesis 31 when they were making an agreement with Jacob. Jagarishahanduda is also an African language, and I can understand it because it is stones of separation. So Jagarishahanduda, Aram, the Aramite people. An old man called Laban has spoken. He has made it up with Jacob, and he has blessed Jacob, and they are living with the children of his children, who are called the children of Israel. But the daughters who have borne these children are Aram, and they are speaking the language I can understand. So Africa, wake up and continue loving God. You know, Africa, we love God so much. Respect God, understand him, know how he wants you to worship him, and then you will be free. Spiritually, you will be free, and you will heal the world. Thank you very much. Continue liking, subscribing, but most of all, for those people who are sharing my video, I thank you so much. That is the part that you have to do. This is a great work to awaken Africa, to make it arise so that it can help the world. Share as much as possible this program, and let people discuss and get healed. We are children of Abraham. We have already seen it in the Bible. And even our land, which is called Africa, is in the Bible. It is during the death of Elisha, the Arams in Afek, and this is Africa. We are Arams, and we are in the Bible. Thank you very much. Continue, and may God show you his love. Continue showering you with a lot of blessings. And I too love you. I'm here to serve you always. Thank you so much. May God bless you. Bless you so much, Africa.